times, so not going to be available here. And I think Giants start with the obvious one.
Yeah, Gnar always, almost always, going to be banned on the red side. Correct myself there, because yesterday we did see multiple Gnar picks to mixed success. Two wins, one loss, but still very strong. Fresh and Jace will be the next two bans to join out that roster of champions not being played in this game.
Interesting they go for Jace. That means that either Zed or Lee Sin is going to be available for Millennium to first pick away, but with Kha'Zix banned out as well, I feel like they could look to first pick Horro, here's Lee Sin here. So one of two champions is not going to be available.
Yeah, okay. So here comes the Kha'Zix ban aimed at the opposing jungler of Frederick. We saw him play that before. Lee Sin gets banned out. And first pick of Jarvan for Millennium, giving that one to Horro.
So it fits Horro's playstyle, very aggressive. It's a champion we've seen Millennium just playing in the last couple of weeks. Had mixed success, actually, as I believe in a game that was against Virtus Pro, we saw Horro jump in quite a lot and get caught off at the beginning of fights before anybody else was there. So gotta watch out for Horro on Jarvan. Perhaps it's not as comfortable as they would like it to be, but obviously first picking it, they feel very, very strongly about that.
Right, and on the opposing side, Giants are actually fairly fast with these lock-ins. Irelia comes out, followed by the Janna, and Irelia, up until this point, has 8 wins and 1 loss.
And interesting that Kevin wants to fight that Irelia with a Rumble here as well, because that's not typically the lane matchup that you would see. You'd typically see the Maokai picked up just to kind of outlast and go to teamfights. But speaking of teamfights, look at what Millennium are already setting up for. Equalizer Cataclysm, the mid-game damage spike from Corki is going to do wonders as well.
Yeah, they already know what they're looking for in this composition. And we're talking about win rates. Corki during the EU LCS expansion tournament so far, 10 wins and 1 loss.
That's not all that surprising. I think Corki's win rate has been very high since Worlds. Just in general has been first picked in a lot of tournaments. So hey, that's just backing up exactly what all of these players know and why they're prioritizing Corki very highly. But Janna got locked in as disengage after the Jarvan. I think that's a very smart pickup there by Giants. It isn't exactly what Rydal likes to play down in that bottom lane. He does prefer melee supports, but those are two different picks.
Yeah, Lee's coming out here now, most likely going to be in the jungle. Don't know where else that could be thrown, but Jinx as well as the AD carry for Giants, swapping it up, and another couple fast lock-ins. Ahri comes out, and hello, Annie.
Annie has not seen play ever since a heavy spate of nerfs. Speaking of nerfs, but heavy nerfs to Annie's early game damage that got adjusted onto AP ratios actually took her out of the competitive play. There was a lot that went on with Annie after Season 3 Worlds. She had a good few patches where nerf after nerf after nerf hit her. So Jayree is playing a champion we haven't seen a long, long time. But this is a lot of magic damage, actually, out of Millennium. Corki, Rumble, Ahri, Annie.
Lots of magic damage. I mean, you do have Corki there for the AD and, of course, the jungler. But, you know, this is a lot more of an AP-centric composition than we're used to.
Mid lane pick is left for Pepperino. What's it going to be? We know that this could be his favorite champion right now. He plays a lot of Twisted Fate.
You know, we were actually predicting Twisted Fate to be banned here. And
yes,
we completely skipped over that. Twisted Fate comes in. That gets thrown over to Pepperino. They're looking for early game dominant and roaming with the jungler. What better to facilitate that type of playstyle?
So what they normally like to do is run Jarvan and Twisted Fate and get kills early on. I guess Elise Twisted Fate has a very similar setup. The fact that you have that single target stun out from Pepperino and Frederick, of course. So early game kills are what they're going to look for here with this combination. And hopefully that will help them against Millennium here. Obviously going to be that Twisted Fate in the middle lane. He's running Ghost.
Yeah, it took a little while to do that. I was like, you're going to want to swap their mates, TF jungle. Not really what you want to be looking for, but yes, indeed. These compositions are looking very interesting and pretty much as planned for these teams as well.
Yeah, so Millennium on their side, they're going to have a lot of AoE crowd control, a lot of AoE damage for team fights. And then over on Giant's side of things, that's a fair amount of single target damage. And obviously, once you get that kill, Jinx is going to get excited. And from their team fights, you're able to catch up very quickly.
Yeah, they like the skirmish. They like their pick comps. We saw that last week. We have the hard evidence, and then we see this now being picked up. This is what they like to play. Is it a little bit too predictable? That's the question. But you mentioned a little while back as well, Stress, that you're talking about their game up against Na'Vi. And That was in the Black Monster Cup. We were looking at like the limited sample size of games we've seen from the new Millennium lineup. And we don't know how strong they're going to be, honestly. But from that small sample size, yes, they kind of stuck to their guns and just continued with pick compositions. And this is like the Millennium that we knew from the LCS.
Yeah.
And we have to see if they change up their style, because we knew that this one-dimensional play style did not work out. But anyway, guys, we are getting onto the Rift, and we are getting into this second series. In fact, the very last series of the second round of the EU LCS expansion tournament. Let's see which team reigns victorious as Millennium come in onto the blue side in the bottom left. And of course, Giants in the upper right, trying to take off the title from Millennium.
Indeed, and Millennium are kind of running a fair amount of pick. Which, does that bode well? Have they sorted out their issues? Have two players changed up everything they want to do? Because it doesn't look like it so far. But what it does look like is Giants perhaps have planned for a little bit of a different start to this game. But a ward from Jayri would go a long way to making sure they don't actually get an invade. But are they expecting it? That is the question.
They're sat here, and it may not even be an invade here, Stress. It may be a Ryu stepping a little bit too far forwards. A stun card to the face and the rest of the team from the flank could result in a very early kill. What are they looking for? Playing the patient hunter. Rydal decides to walk out the bush. Does that give the game away? Everyone else is sticking around.
There you go. It gave the game away. As soon as they saw Rydal there, that's a very strange position for a support to be in. So Millennium would have known exactly what was up in that situation. But, I mean, it was a nice attempt by Giants. Maybe punishing a little bit of overconfidence, because if there's one area that we know players from all regions can very much so get caught out, is that little bit of overconfidence when you're coming into a game. I mean, that's one of the problems that plagued the Samsung teams at Worlds, was they were a bit overconfident at times. Didn't really matter too much in the end of all things, but the difference is it would go a long way to boost Giants' confidence.
It would indeed. And now as we get into the bot lane, we did see Kreatin push up into that bush, but decided to back off and start on equal footing with his counterparts of Rydal and Adri. Picking up that Jinx this game as well. So a little bit of a different AD carry from what we've been seeing, which is basically Corki Lucian every single game.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of Corki Lucian, but Jinx is a champion we see from time to time against Corki, because essentially you scale very well into the late game. So yeah. That is what Giants are going to look for. Get the picks in the early game, set their opponents a little far behind, and take towers down like there's no tomorrow.
So, I'm interested in this mid lane, because ex-Peppy, or Pepperino as he's otherwise known, is going to be finding a lot of Frederick in his lane, I have to feel. In both of the games we've seen them, in all the games they've pretty much played, he basically sees himself as mid lane as his second home, that being from Frederick.
Yeah, and it's honestly getting towards the time we're expecting to see, and that's a lot of damage in the top lane, though. But Frederick is, I would say, fairly easy to read, so I wouldn't be surprised to see Horror there at the same time for a counter gank. I think both teams will be expecting Frederick to be mid lane fairly shortly, and you can see by Frederick's pathing that he is, in fact, heading towards that middle lane.
Funnily enough, here he comes. Bottom side this time around. Can he get something done? Haro is hovering around the top side of mid lane, however. Maybe
gold card.
Doing,
oh, nope,
you know,
blue.
That initial research on the team. Run card, mate. You do want a different one there. There's, now here comes Frederick. Here's another picker card. Here comes the gold card. But here comes Haro right on cue. Flag and drag comes forwards. And they carry on with the chase, looking for another stun card. Flashes over the wall, does burn that summoner. Ryu gets tanked by the wild cards on the way out. Summoners exchanged from both teams.
Millennium had to know that was coming, and that was double flash used there. And actually, only just the ghost used from Giants. That's a big set of summoners down for Millennium, and that's a very small win to begin this game. And I would say it's larger than small.
Yeah, it sets them up for the next couple minutes. They'll just be quite happy to go again, try his luck. Frederick, you know, he'll try his luck in different lanes, but mid lane is really where his heart lies. As he heads into the top lane, there was a fair amount of trading between these two top laners. Whirly B, Kevin as well. You know, Kevin is Kevin in this top lane, playing fairly consistent. That's what we know from Kevin. He is the consistent top laner. Apart from the end of the season where it started to go a little bit awry and became overly aggressive, we'll have to see if he fixes those issues as this is his first competitive showing.
It is, but I think there are a couple of other challenger top laners that really would stamp that in their estimation, they're probably at least on par with Kevin right now. So there's a lot of talent here in challenger. I want to bring things to the bottom lane. And we asked, why did they lock this Annie in? I have a feeling it's the burst damage in lane, and then, of course, the Tibbers engage. But middle lane...
Oh, the charm lands, and so does the Sunlock. Maybe not laid quite correctly, but is it still enough? He does have the stacked deck ready for the extra damage. Flashes forward. However, he does have tank up the turret. That'll be a one-for-one, but the assist does go to Giants.
Yeah, they got the kill from it using Flash Hat to get it, but I think Pepperino will be somewhat happy with that. That's the initial kill that they needed, but they gave one to Ahri.
Frederick has been caught out here by Horro, and he is not getting the better of this trade, especially with the red buff. He's continuing to chain his auto attacks, but Elise will get the repel to the minions. Does Horro have another couple seconds on this flank and drag, but gets cocooned? Horro knows he can't go any further and will be able to pick up the kill on the Spider Queen.
Ooh, that was... touch and go for a second there from Frederick. Thought perhaps he might get caught, but he knew he had it all under control after that rappel went off. But that's the aggressiveness that those summoners being down in the middle lane has already opened up. So, I mean, that's a lot of pressure being put on mid lane at the start of this game.
It is indeed. We'll see if they keep up that pressure. Right, so mobility boots being picked up. So, we're just talking about pressure. That basically sells it in an item choice from Frederick.
Indeed. That means Frederick is just going to want to get into the enemy jungle and mid lane, probably. I would imagine at estimate we're going to see it again, but there's the Destiny popped.
But no gate.
Well, so the first Destiny and gate usage of the game is normally very integral because you typically pick up a kill or two from it. I have a feeling it was because Millennium were pushing up very far in the bottom lane.
Yeah.
But what the Destiny gave them vision of was Horro standing around Dragon. So not really the engage that you want from that one.
Yeah. He sent a message, though. I know where you all are on this map. We have the advantage for the next 5 seconds until my ult wears off.
Vision control. Nailed it.
Nailed it. Got it down. I'm talking about vision. They are actually behind. Look at all the wards coming out from Millennium. They are in control around the river. And even some aggressive wards into that jungle as well. Look at Giants. Basically starved out of vision.
And Millennium have swapped up a couple of their trinkets already, so they are on the way to controlling vision for certain. But this is currently Giant's lead from that first blood.
They do have that lead. It's a very slight lead, but they'll take anything they can get as we get into 7 minutes 30 seconds into this game. Now, Ryu heads back into this middle lane, and you know, after that initial flurry of action from Frederick in that mid lane action, he's actually just kind of backed off a little bit. Yes, the buffs have spawned, and that's probably your priority over mid lane right now. I would like to see if he returns there and tries to put more pressure down.
That is the question. We've expected it. We're expecting it so much that Millennium are warding heavily for it. You can see that they've got a pink ward in the lower bush, wards around the top side of mid lane and the bottom side, so no way is Ryu really getting caught out here. If he does, that is... all on him, but Millennium are looking, I guess they're looking as people expected them right now. I mean, this is only 8 minutes into this game. There's still a lot longer to go before this series is decided. And Giants right now, they're going to sit on their small lead.
They are, and you know, talking about top lane as well, we haven't spoken about that for a couple other minutes, but Kevin is actually ahead in farm. He's been gradually getting ahead over Whirlybee. We saw that he did have a couple issues there over the last couple minutes, and that has been shown in the CS difference.
So, big moment has just hit. Level 6 in the bottom lane means Flash Tibbers is available for Annie, and this is going to signal perhaps the start of this Dragon phase of the game where they're going to look to control that Dragon Pit. But both teams back away, a little bit too afraid of the engage potential.
Yeah, kind of just saw each other and was like, I don't think we want this fight right now. Both of the teams thinking the exact same thing. will be backing away. However, Haro aggressing into this jungle here. Frederick is fairly low on health, and there's a Cataclysm. There's the Flying Drag as well, past the Flash. But the ultimate will be used from Pepperino. Ryu will be coming in to assist. Jinx Rocket flies past the fight. No one's dropping just yet, but Pepperino lands that gold card, and Elise is coming in from around the side. Volatile setup, Spiderling won't be enough as Ryu flashes over the wall. Incredibly close, Rydell comes in and just tags him with an auto attack, says hi, takes him down. Bottom lane, however, he left his AD carry out to dry.
At the same time, just all around the map, Giants pick up a kill in the mid lane and trade one in the bottom, but the race is on to get the damage done to the turrets in this situation. And Millennium right now are gonna, I think, trade that turret. Is it actually gonna go down? That is the question. They are gonna get the bottom one. Yes.
There we go. Oh, no, creating stops. But it will be going down in the next couple of minutes.
He wanted to deny the large wave. Yeah. That was exactly what he wanted, but didn't really have too much more time to buy.
Yeah, Pepperino only really needs to sneeze on the middle lane, and that one will go down as well. But everyone has gone back, have picked up their initial items. Jinx, of course, picked up the BF sword, looking towards her first a big item. And then a lot of the components from Creighton, well on his way to his Trinity Force.
He is well on the way. He is going up against the BF sword, though, on Jinx, but the big CS difference for this top lane.
Yeah, and Frederick comes in from the side. That is a dead Kevin. He is not going anywhere. Equalizer comes down. And we'll net a couple CS, small consolation prizes, he drops to the top laner.
Giants are doing a good job at keeping the lead that they had, but can they do a good enough job to deter the dragon as well? Because they just showed top lane with their jungler. It's a long walk down here as well.
Well, Millennium have started this one up. Zaf does not connect. Creighton comes in from around the side, and Millennium decide to pull the plug. They are bought. And now that Frederick comes in from the side, they'll just carry on starting the dragon. This may be a little bit risky, but they're taking it down so quickly. Here comes the teleport, the smite comes out. Frederick will secure it. The teleport actually gets cancelled from Kevin. Whirly B does commit, however. Jayree gets a good start onto Whirly B, followed up by the charm from Ryu, keeps him in his place.
Giants are just taking every lead that they can get right now, and Millennium are kind of behind the game here. You have to think that Millennium should have expected, mid lane focus, the chart of, Cocoon landed, but the turret stays alive for now.
Giants, after that initial gold lead, have managed to keep that going. They are around 2,000 gold ahead at this point stress, which is pretty much what they wanted to do. They have this early game advantage. We'll see if they can do much more of it. That has just been increased just by a little way with that middle turret going down as well. That'll be converted into a couple more items. That'll be for certain as Twisted Fate now looking towards his Sheen, looking towards his Lich Bane as well. And if we look at the warding, Giants have definitely regained control over that map.
They have. The amount of wards in the lower side of the river and the jungle just in general means that Giants are looking pretty good right now, and they want to get another tower for themselves, but Creighton is there. Let's take a quick look at the items. There is the Lich Bane, just got picked up by Pepperino. No Trinity Force as yet for Corki, and Jinx currently set on 1100 gold. He's going to get a little bit closer to that Infinity Edge, but right now, Giants just playing this one fairly safe. They're not making any risky plays. And look at the stat line on Ari, 1-2-0. It's been good focus onto Ryu this far in this game.
Yeah, we called on the mountain to climb. These big OGN champions coming out here so far haven't necessarily shown up after that initial double flashes being burnt. Giants have just continued to keep up the pressure. Here comes the gate. Coming in from the top side this time, he does in fact use it. Jayree with the tip is coming down, the stun comes out. Frederick now follows through, but the counter gank from Horror, will this be enough to deter them? The answer is a resounding yes. They do not pick up any kills from this one.
Giants used a lot though. They did, however, get the tibbers from Jayree, but that is a lot of their fighting potential. Was it enough to deter them from the turret? Doesn't really matter because Ari has taken mid in exchange. So I think Millennium will be okay with that trade.
Yes, they will. Take that bottom turret again, evening up the turrets once again. So they will be keeping us even. Ryu doesn't land the charm, doesn't land the combo following it. Pepperino will take away his blue buff with not too much of a contest. Had that charm landed though, and Twisted Fate would not have had a good day. That being said, Deathfire Grasp has not been completed yet, but you probably wouldn't expect it at 14 minutes into the game regardless. Vision Control is again the name of the game from Giants.
It is the name of the game, but the funny thing about that Ryu not landing the charm there was that was actually fairly blind. You could see Pepperino swept for a ward afterwards, and that was just Ryu's instincts, saying, Blue's about to come up, let's head over there, caught a glimpse of it.
Oh, but and this time the charm lands and will be followed up by Annie. Ryu uses his ultimate, here comes the Spirit Rush and still has another couple charges. We'll pretend we ignored that face plant into the wall and just pick up the kill.
No need to pretend. Caught it right on the screen. So Ryu goes from... Ooh, top lane.
Oh, Wordy B. One-on-one versus Kevin. And despite this CS gap, that does not matter. But Jayri comes in from the bottom lane. Kevin is silenced, ticking down, but does not die. And support Annie is angry and looking for this kill. Can't quite get in range, though. But Ahri is coming from around the side. So is Haro. And they secure the kill. And actually still goes to Jayri.
Millennium are starting to find their footing in this game. They're starting to get the ball rolling from these picks like this. And you said it, Millennium picks. That is how they played through LCS. And now they're playing it through the expansion tournament to get back in the LCS. So nothing really has changed in their play style with these two new players, the two headline Korean players. So is it enough?
That is the big question, Stress. That is the story for Millennium. They were way too predictable in LCS. They had an 11-game losing streak all the way up into promotions. Then the only time they managed to pick up games was against Unicorns of Love, who actually beat them 3 times in a row to take the series 2-3, take them out of LCS. And even from the challenger teams, you were too predictable. And if you are still using pick compositions, yes, it will work against a couple teams, but people will start being able to just counteract this, and they cannot default to this stress.
I guess they can default to it. They just need more. They need more in their playbook.
They can't be a one-trick pony.
Exactly. You can't do that. Otherwise, they're going to just end up like the team one-trick pony. If anybody remembers the 2013 play-ins for NA LCS, but that was a long time ago, and I'm showing my age. But anyway, into this game. Millennium have the lead. Well, no, they don't have the lead right now. Actually, Giants still have the lead as we take a look. 1,000 is the exact number, but where does that come from? Let's take another look. That was the last dragon that spawned. And as dragon comes up in 30 seconds, Millennium will have to look to secure that one for themselves.
They will indeed. And as they gear up for this next dragon, everyone does go back to base. And Irelia, in fact, goes back to base, picks up the Trinity Force at 17 minutes, not too shabby. We'll be ready to surround this area. Pings come down, and this is definitely the next point of contention for both Giants and Millennium. Again, Charm has breath away from landing onto a Giants member. And just one stun, followed up by the rest of the CC, will be a dead person and a dead objective following it. But Kevin takes the top turret. He does have his teleport. Irelia is already in the action, though.
So it's already a net gain so far for Millennium. Here comes the Destiny, though. Where's it going on to?
Oh, he comes in for the engage. Horror actually gets stunned up here, and he will go for this one. And the Kevin is teleporting into the back lines. Willy B is getting incinerated. Here comes the Equalizer right across the team. Kevin actually gets punted back to his team by Rydell. He'll be quite happy to run away here. Pepperino, though, comes in with the triple. Can he make this the Penta? He is following up here. And actually, Horror will get behind his turret. But a 4-0. What a team fight.
Pepperino shows up huge in that team fight. Uses the Destiny. Gets the gold card down onto the only surviving member of the fight on Haro, and at this point Giants are looking fantastic. We just talked about how the picks were working out for Millennium, but we know this is Giants playstyle. You get the pick, you follow up with the team fight, and Millennium weren't willing to commit. Kevin teleports right into the middle of everybody from Giants, and from there the Monsoon disengages Kevin out of the fight, and they just follow up with some sublime Twisted Fate play.
Yeah, and if your strategy is to play pick compositions, you better make sure you're good at them. Because if you're getting outplayed by another team who is doing pick compositions and they're doing it better, then you need to find something else. Because currently, Millennium suffering from the same issues. 3,000 gold behind, lost the dragon, falling behind in this game. They need to make some quick iterations.
The problem is, for Millennium, a lot of their pick potential comes from mid lane, and Giants have put so much focus on mid lane But it's been hard for Ryu actually to get himself into this game without some fantastic plays on his own. But the focus has swapped up a little bit up to that top lane, but Kevin had backed away. Millennium, however, are on the aggressive path here and want to at least get wards down. They've swapped up all of their trinkets. They want to get control of the top lane vision.
Yeah, Giants are not too far behind them on the trinket war. Only the blue trinket needs to go from Adri. And we all have the full set for the transition. They moved into that jungle, trying to get a little bit of an advantage here. And with that aggressive play, they'll move into the middle lane. And despite being behind, they're not sitting there and just waiting for the inevitable. They aren't trying to make their own plays. And 20 minutes into the game, Pepperino will be heading into the bot lane himself and just doing the split push strategy with his ultimate. There's a lot of mobility on this team of Giants.
Giants have got to be careful for a flash Tibbers here, because Destiny was used just to get the vision here for Giants, but he's actually having to use it defensively. Flash Tibbers in a 5v4 situation for Millennium would be huge. Even if they only caught one or two people, that would be enough to set this fight off.
It would, and now it has just become a staring contest between these two teams. Despite all of that, Millennium are the one who are on the aggression. And next, Pepe will say, all right, I guess I'll go back to bot lane and take your turrets. And while you're being indecisive, we take away from this.
That was the exact word I was going to use, was Millennium are being indecisive. But do they want to engage
now?
Oh,
here comes the Jayree with the Tibbers, the Wombo combo. Oh. Double kill for Kreaton. And make that the third kill of the fight. It will be the Repel coming up, but what comes up must come down. Frederick gets caught out here. Phosphorus bomb, triple kill for Kreaton.
But how much can be done the other side of the map? Frederick, or ex-Pepe, is in front of an inhibitor turret with no minions right yet, so it looks like they're going to trade inhibitor turrets at the least, but Millennium should be able to push the inhibitor as well.
But here comes Kevin. He will be stopping that push. Middle inhibitor turret goes down at 21 minutes. It was looking so good for Giants, but that big trip up has resulted in the inhibitor going down. Rydal gets hit by the charm. They will not choose to commit. Now they just need to get out cleanly.
Oh, Ryu.
Boy, turns around, has been exhausted, and Adri was saying, okay, I guess I'll pick up this kill, but still, it's a consolation prize for losing two turrets and an inhibitor and a huge team fight.
The problem is, the Giants just try and rush a Baron here. I mean, they know that Millennium are backing away, and they're moving in that way. They can at least get the vision down. That is one saving grace for Giants, but let's roll it all the way back to that fight. It's what we said. If Twisted Fate... Well, Twisted Fate wasn't able to get to the fight, but the Tibbers engage from Jayree was just too strong. 5v4, Millennium would take that fight all day. Kreaton cleans up. He's sitting pretty at 4-1 and 2 right now. And honestly, Giants had to expect that. As soon as Pepperino used his ultimate, that is a massive cooldown no longer available. If he doesn't recall immediately from that, Millennium give the go-ahead.
Yeah, it's all great having that mobility with your teleports, but if you preemptively use them, then you won't be there for the fight. And a team like Millennium, they have the experience, at least individually, to say, this is our time to strike. That's what we saw in the middle lane. But everyone has gone back to base, they've recuperated. Now, that was a big item acceleration from Ryu in the mid lane. Last time we looked, only had the makings of a Deathfire Grass. Now he has the item, and a Morella Namakan, and a Sorcerer's Boots.
And importantly, alongside that, he's also got wards, and that has been the name of the game for Millennium. You can see they've got more on the map than Giants, even though Giants just got their wards down. So it's only a matter of time now before Millennium try and secure a bit more vision control around that Baron Pit for themselves. But I don't think Giants are going to want to make a similar play with Pepperino. But Giants are still ahead in the gold, and Dragon is coming up again in a minute's time. And you have to feel like Giants are doing a great job so far against Millennium. A lot of people would have counted them out by now, but we're 23 minutes into this game, and they have controlled the map very well. Pepperino is always going to be a presence here. His ultimate is available again. He can drop to the bottom lane, look to split push that turret in again should he choose to. And they're only really worried of Jayree's engage. Giants just have to play it out smart.
It's true, but it's definitely been hit and miss for them. We look at the laning phase, and it was really hit and miss. Pepperino uses his ultimate, doesn't commit. Then that's his first big ultimate, literally doing squat. Then we get later into the game. Yes, we have a good gank here and there. Then the quadra kill, pretty good for Pepperino. But then following that, not a good ultimate. So it's one after another, one thing working, one thing not.
And something that may not work is this Baron bait, because there's the Destiny. It's pretty difficult to do a Baron bait, but this is a great play, actually, because they're going to get a free inhibitor turret from it.
Yeah, gate goes down, and now it's just a stalling game from the rest of Giants. Whirly Bee and Pepperino will be tearing apart this inhibitor, and they bring the inhibitor count 1-1.
That is a great
down.
Play.
And in fact, they're not looking for more. They were thinking about it. Pepperino, but now they might get caught off.
They have to back away, but Pepperino's still got Ghost and Flash. Whirly Bee still has his Flash, too, so they're out of this completely scot-free, and that was a big power play by Giants. They have such a dangerous composition for just doing that, that is now a massive weakness for Millennium. If they do that every time Baron is available and then the inhib comes up, Millennium have somebody stuck in their base, and they need that full team fight to really go against this strong Giants lineup.
This is an incredibly smart game from both teams. One team is slightly out of position, the other team recognizes it. Case in point, they take the dragon. Here comes Millennium responding with a Baron, and they are absolutely choked on vision. Giants do not know this is happening. This is Baron going down for Millennium at 25 minutes.
Yeah, I mean, that's the double-edged sword, though, is they push the bottom lane. Because of it, they didn't have the ability to secure the Baron pit. So yes, they got the inhibitor. The question now is, which is the favored objective for them? You have to feel like Millennium with Baron. And now going to feel very confident that Giants actually can't do anything for the next couple of minutes in this game.
Yeah, and we've seen from team fights, albeit it was a 5-4, that Millennium are definitely stronger. And hell, we look at the composition, we spoke about it in Champion Select, it will be winning on a straight-up brawl. Next, Pepperino, yes, he's strong, yes, he had the Quadra, and yes, he's farming well, but it won't be standing up to the might that is Rumble, Cataclysm, Ryu coming into the mix, plus a Jerry on top with a Tibbers.
Well, if the game wasn't up, but gold card in the bottom lane, but Equalizer was used. That's I guess he did use Ghost, actually, so it's not so much of a free cooldown, but Pepperino is caught without his ultimate.
And he is gone, and he just teleports right into Ryu, the worst place you could possibly choose, has to burn his flash as well, and Ryu jumps over the wall. Can he respond with a kill? Here comes the Zonyas. Kevin, you probably do want to finish him off. Ryu will do that for you. Rydal comes into here as well, wants to say, hey, take me as well. We'll also get taken down, a 2-0 for Millennium.
Outer turret for inhib turret, inhibitor is not going to be the good trade there, so Ryu caught up a lot of distance there, catching up to the actual teleport from Twisted Fate there, managed to just pick up basically an uncontested kill. Giants had the lead. Now they don't have Baron, now they have an inhibitor down as well. The gold is still in Giants' favor, but the amount of stats that Baron buff is going to give Millennium essentially makes this an even game.
Yeah, it is dead even, and we've seen that. All that has really decided the gold momentum and the swings of control over this game stress has been the teams making great shot calls to create advantages for themselves out of weaknesses that they spot. It has not been them bumping into each other 5-on-5 and seeing who reigns supreme.
No, it hasn't been that so much, but it has been a very mid lane centric game. I mean, you look at the stat lines across the board, 5-3-1 for Pepperino, 4-4-4 for Ryu, and that's what we expected coming into this game. I think everybody basically said that Ryu is so good right now in this mid lane role, and Giants have put a magnifying glass on it, and they've said, that is where we think your weakness is right now. We don't really care so much about your bottom lane. We want to put Ryu as far behind in this game as possible because the communication may not be there. And Giants have done a good job of it so far. The question is, how do they turn that into a game one win?
Well, ex-Pepperino was trying to find someone just a couple centimeters away from his team, a straggler perhaps that he could capitalize on. In fact, he'll just opt towards the minions in top lane, but that's him without his both summoners and without his ultimate, and that means the rest of the team has to back off to the base.
Yeah, it does. I mean, he has got the distortion enchant, but it's bottom lane that there might be some disruption.
You have a flash, I have a flash. Horror comes in with the cataclysm, creating follows up with the damage, but Horror is actually getting sliced and diced up by Whirly Bee. It will be the flag and drag to finish him off, however, a nice 1-0 clean sweep.
Horror gets away just with his life. The rocket is not going to come through. But that nearly was the example that we've seen. Horro going in aggressively and getting picked off, but he managed to survive through because the rest of his team was there for once. So Millennium's still showing a couple of issues here that we've seen that has plagued them throughout Challenger for the last few weeks.
Seems like they are shaking it off. 1:30 until the dragon, of course, not the main objective currently at this stage in the game. Millennium now aggressing into this jungle, again keeping up with their vision control. A little bit patchy at the moment, and largely clear skies, but now as they head into the bottom lane, they will be able to hack away at this bottom inner turret. Giants are definitely not in position to contest this. Here comes a shield, but down goes your turret. Kevin following up here, doesn't land the electro harpoons, and they turn up the heat.
Jayri once again has the flash tibbers available, and he's actually had a lot more impact this game than we've seen out of Millennium in a while. 2-1-8 on Annie has been a very good game for Jayri, so if he can get another prize engage, you may very well see another inhibitor going down here, but the timer is ticking up on the inhibitor that is down in the middle lane. That'll be back up soon, and only 40 seconds until Dragon. This is Millennium's siege time, but can they get that big engage?
That's true. 30 seconds until Dragon, but I highly doubt they'll be like, all right, guys, yes, we are pushing into their base, but hey, Wraiths are up. Well, let's go take those. But at the moment,
that
stalemate, but not anymore. Here comes Azoni's Hourglass, but he's still ticking down from the Ignite. The last charge of Spirit Rush will take out their star player. And 50 seconds down for the count, Millennium will make this one count.
They will. They're going to get both inhibs off this because the second one will respawn. They've still got their engage tool, and Millennium are looking very good now, even though they've been playing from behind.
They have been playing from behind, but this game has been as equal as you could get. Yes, Millennium are now in control, but it could go either way. Giants with a good engage could still turn this one around. Probably not 4 versus 5, as Millennium will take away both of their inhibitors, one left remaining in their base. Dragon is live, so is Blue. They just pinged it. Looks like their plan of attack.
Yeah, and the plan of attack is pick up the buffs, head back to the base, grab that Baron buff if they feel they need it, and then close this one out. So
sounds good on paper.
It does. It sounds good on paper, but so do pick comps. And that has been Millennium's trouble. But I feel like they're comfortably ahead in this game now. They've been playing as if they were ahead from behind for a while now. So Millennium probably will be a bit surprised to find out they were behind in this game.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. It's very rare we see a team who, you know, yes, behind by only a couple thousand gold, which doesn't, in the grand scheme of things at this stage in the game, matter all that much, but you never see them this far on the offensive.
Ooh, Haro,
and
though,
taking away everything away, but Haro has been caught out. Super Mega Death Rocket takes them down. This is the start of a good team fight for Giants. Here comes the teleport, instant Zonyas, and Jayri gets caught out as well. Make that 2-0 for Giants. Whirly B will join the death count for this team fight. 3 players die, 2-1 for Giants.
Massive equalizer though out of Kevin meant that nobody could really follow up from Giants. All the way through that jungle was zoned away. But Millennium, maybe that's a little bit of a pause button here. Blue trinkets were used on the Baron, so they know it wasn't being taken down. But Millennium, you can see it very cautiously working their way up to the Baron. They will find nobody there.
No, they will not. But they will find a pink ward, and Kevin will take that 30 gold to the bank. Ex-Pepperino sitting in his base, having to play the janitor role as he clears out these super minions and stopping them from taking his base.
The role he hasn't been able to play, though, in the last 10 or so minutes has been that split push role that he started so well in this game. Remember, they took that inhib turret and the inhibitor by that play from Irelia and Pepperino. And they haven't been able to do that again because Millennium are pushing up too much. There's no real way of Giant split pushing if Millennium are just forcing their way into the base as a 5-man unit. And that is a problem that Giants are going to have to overcome. Try and catch somebody out and prevent Millennium from grouping up.
Well, the alarm bells are ringing and Giants are grouping up to try and stop another Baron from being swept out from beneath their noses. And the ping does go bot lane, and those two bear inhibitors, in fact they are dead, those two dead inhibitors are kind of a big issue for Giants. They have to make a decisive play, and Millennium do not have a care in the world. Hey, I can see you. We did see you a couple seconds with that ward, but now I definitely know you're there.
If at first you don't succeed, try and try again. But that doesn't work, because Pepperino's ultimate is too good for spotting out if somebody's doing Baron, so They're going to have to try again. Now they may be able to get it, because Ultimate's not available, but I don't think Giants are going to be that stupid.
But the blue trinket did go down, and now they actually have to get near the pit to try and place down another ward. Cocoon lands onto Ryu, but this Baron is dying really, really quickly from Millennium. Whirly B comes in from the top side. Giants go all in. Whirly B is actually pretty tanky at this stage, but here comes the Cataclysm, followed up by the Equalizer. Horror will be falling, but now everyone else dies from Giants. This is a back and forth fight if I've ever seen one. Jiri gets taken out. Ryu from the side lands the charm onto Antri, followed through by S. Pepperino. A 3-for-3. So far, who can clean up the fight? Oh, Creatine from the back lines from downtown picks up the kill. Adri now on a 1v2, can't juke the phosphorus bomb. 5-for-3. What can Millennium take off this?
A great equalizer again by Kevin, but the damage from Giants, they might actually look to push the game. The Nexus turret fell in that engage.
Yeah, I'll tell you what they can take away from this game's stress. They'll take the game. Kevin tries his best, but the inhibitors respawn. I feel like we've seen this one before. Can they take it down in time? Because Rydal is 2 seconds away from coming out. Frederick as well. They're against the clock.
They can't get the game from that. So Millennium thought they'd won that game. The GGs even came out. But all the way back, Kevin lands a very nice equalizer in that engage. The damage follow-up from Pepperino and Adri was so much that Millennium thought they'd actually lost that fight. Luckily, though, they turn around and create and unloads a massive amount of damage. He's now 7-1-6. Just picked up another couple of items to go alongside his build. And Creatine, everybody was kind of umming and ahhing about how Millennium's other players would be in this lineup. And Creatine is definitely putting on a good showing.
Yeah, put those questions to rest for sure. 7-1-6 in this game, 250 CS to boot, plus a pretty good item build for this stage in the game. Of course, Pepperino did use his ultimate again for Vision to get himself in range as well, but here comes Baron Attempt round two. Are we going to see rinse and repeat? A carbon copy of the last fight, perhaps. Kevin trying to zone them away. They do have that vision control. This could get messy, and this could get messy real fast. It will be Ahri securing the Baron. Little too close for comfort, perhaps. Millennium saying, good smite, Horror, good smite.
Yeah, it didn't quite line up. Didn't even use smite, yeah. Actually. So looks like a big spike of damage went down at the end. But they've caught Frederick out. He's in his lower side jungle. This is Millennium's inhibitor to take now. And considering the health of that Nexus turret, Kevin's going to equalize it as soon as he sees a couple of people. And Millennium are probably just going to win the game off this. But can Giants do anything to deter that? Can they put up one last big fight here against Millennium? There's their charm.
Here comes Last Chance Saloon, and it's not going well as Creatine picks up the kill onto the Repel Delise. Whirly B gets decimated, and X Pepperino tries to do everything he can, but it's just too little, too late. 3-for-0, and this should be the game, but Millennium are fairly low. Andre, if he could pull off a miracle, now is the time to shine, but if Rydal gets pushed back, it will be them taking down the Nexus, and that was a hard-fought victory by Millennium in this first game of this best of three up against Giants.
Giants, I mean, Millennium looked strong at the end of the game. Millennium looked a lot more coordinated at the end of the game, but Giants' game plan coming into this worked out pretty well for the early game. But at that point, when they got later and later into the game, Millennium really started getting their picks. They started getting the team fights they wanted. Kevin had some great equalizers as well during that game. So Millennium took a minute or two to get going.
They did, because at the start of the game, as soon as we saw that quadra, it was like, Giants have been turning up in this game. And plus the start as well, up against this big mountain, we hyped it up before we went into Champion Select, and they did a pretty good job of trying to counteract these two big Korean raid bosses, but then, as we got later into the game, it didn't work out as well. However, the gold totals, it was completely even. That was a pretty good game from both sides, and Giants just need to continue playing like that and just find more opportunities like they did in that bottom lane, because they did respond with that inhibitor. They did respond all guns firing.
Yeah, that was a big, big play that we saw out of Irelia and Twisted Fate in that mid-game phase. But honestly, I feel like Millennium, they were just looking shaky at the beginning, got back into the game, and from there you saw the LCS players, the OGN players, start to come out a little bit more. Not to say that Giants couldn't take a game two here. They've already showed us they can get a lead. How can they get a lead and hold on to it, though?
Well, let's find out the